Alright, hello everyone, welcome. So today we are going to talk about the dispersion effect, how we can make a glass to be dispersion usually in real life if light came through a glass. And using the prism theory, it will be, if we have here a light, so it will be separated and divided and analyzed to the basic nature of light, which will be red, green and blue, and you may find a lot of buses, one which will be green and one which will be blue and one which will be yellow and so on. So this is called the dispersion effect. So let's see how we can simulate that in cycles. So firstly I will check our object, and after that I will go to the shading tab, or maybe divide this window. And here we will go to the shader editor, of course, and let's add a new material. I will delete everything and the material output will be here. And after that we will add the refraction. We will use refraction many times here. I will firstly use this one will be red and green will be zero. Let's duplicate this few times. We will use another refraction and another refraction. This one will be green and this one will be blue. So we'll add shader, and after that let's add it here and add it here. Then we will add this one will be here and add this one. So let's connect. So what is the point here? If we merged all this and added a refraction of red, green, blue, we will get an white, because white is combination of red, green and blue. This is everyone knows this theory. And if we render now, we will get very, very noisy image. Let's test that now. Alright, so this is good, but it may be such as a glass, but there is some problem. It's very noisy. So what we will make, we will separate these values. One, this one will be 1 point. Okay, it's white, but it's noisy as I've mentioned. So this one will be separated from IR. So we'll make different IR for each channel so that we can see the dispersion effect. As you can see, we can see it here, and we have made that, but we want one value to, so we'll add value so that we can control of IR in one time. So this one will be 1 point. Okay, this will be 1.45, and this will be mass, and this will be mass. Using the mass node, I will add here from subtract 0.05 and another mass node. So I will add mass node here also, and this one will be add 0.05. So we can't use this nodes, but this will be make it faster to change it 1.5, so that we change one time instead of changing all channels. This is good. What's next? So the next, I will mix shader, not that, mix shader, what's happening here? So mix shader from here, and add a glossy. Of course, zero. Fresnel. Fresnel. And IR of 1.45, or this value, which is IOR. And we can, of course, name it here. Let's call it IOR, or index. Index of refraction IOR. That's fine. Okay, we have made the glass and it's appear now the dispersion effect. Of course we will render, but we will enable in the buses, I will enable the denoising data. And for render, I will check this value and let's choose 500. Let's add camera. Dimensions will be 180. View camera to view. And let's render, but I will choose the film transparent. Let's render our scene. So it has finished rendered in around 1 minute. And be sure if you if you want thick glass, make your index of refraction to be 1.5 or 1.6. And if you want thin glass, 1.45 will do the job. And of course for water, 1.333. So I will go for compositing and check use nodes. And this is our rendered image. Let's control shift on this image to have this noisy. And after that, using the D noise. So it will be here and image to be here. So normal to normal and albedo to albedo. So I think it will be clear. Should be clear now. Let's test. It's now compositing. Let's test this value. Okay, now it's clear. As you can see, it's clear. And we can go for shading for a moment. And because I make IR 1.5, it's the dispersion effect is noticeable and it's large than we expect. So IR of 1.45 for thin, and if you want to increase the dispersion effect, increase only this value. This value will be increased, and this value if you want an dispersion effect to be more. So that's it for this lesson. I hope you enjoy this lesson. See you in another tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Kamel Athami, and see you in the next class.